Let's go. Playing the 60-second burger one game. I've had a bit of practice with it. It's much easier with W, A, S, and D. No! What? It's close, but you can't. No! Alright, let's have another go. Come on. Yes. What? That's crazy.
Yeah. Tricky. Be quiet.
Hello, welcome to Villains Today, the headlines tonight.
Police searching for missing student Tom Jones in Worcester find a body in the River Severn. This has been searching for the 18-year-old since he disappeared in the early hours of Wednesday last week, having only just moved in. Also tonight, the M40 is closed for much of the day after three lorries crashed in the early hours. Looked out the window, the bedroom window, and I could see flames, smoke. Cuts in the classroom. The school sending pupils home early to save money. One of the first freshers at a brand new university now, 3 years on, we catch up with Holly on a historic graduation day.
And it might have felt like some of the messages this week, but the fabric is still more autumnal this weekend, as it arrived in the van in the middle of the day. Mm-hmm.
Police looking for the missing student Tom Jones have confirmed for this evening that they've recovered a body from the river in Worcester, not far where Tom was last seen for the week. There's no confirmation that this is the university student. Police are keeping in touch with Tom's family, who've organised searches and given out leaflets far and wide in the hope of keeping to his whereabouts. I'll put him in the deck with by the side of the cell this evening. And Nicola, what more have the police said?
Well, through the West Mercia Police, late this afternoon, brought us the news that sadly they had recovered a body.
Come on.
They said that sadly officers searching for 18-year-old
Tom Jones had recovered
a body from the District 7 in
Worcester today.
Tom Jones from Bromsgrove had just begun a primary teaching course. He'd been at the Velvet Nightclub in the city centre. The last confirmed sighting of him was close to the River Severn, where he was thought to have crossed the Sabrina Bridge before walking up the footpath at Crossing Road. The response to appeals for help and the search for Tom was described by the police as amazing. 4 days after he was last seen, two men in their 20s were arrested on suspicion of murder. On Monday, they were released without charge and are no longer being treated for suspects. Tom's parents appealed for the public to help him find him. His friends worked tirelessly to assist the police in their inquiries. They searched for the young man, described as a lovely boy.
It's just warning them, we've not been hiding up. I think it drops you off early, so. And yeah, you don't have to wait for the actual thing to go.
One man has died in a three lorry crash and fire on the M40 in Warwickshire in the early
hours. I'm going too late. No, too early, sorry.
In
Junction 16 for Henley in Arden. The southbound carriageway reopens after 14 hours just after 5 o'clock, although there are only two lanes at the scene of the accident. The northbound carriageway, however, remains closed tonight.
The side of the motorway. Witnesses described the lorry fire as like a vision from hell. The driver wasn't injured. Workmen have spent the day clearing debris to repair the southbound carriageway. This man, who lives next to the motorway, said he was woken up at 3 a.m. after seeing flames, smoke, and I realised it had been a large accident on the motorway. And then there were more explosions as well. The short distance here on the opposite carriageway, three lorries collided less than an hour later, causing another fire. The driver believed to be at fault is dying. Two completely separate accidents, leading to a total shutdown of the F40 between Junction 15 and 16 near Warwick.
It's really, really unusual to get an incident on both sides of the carriageway simultaneously. It's put the road network, local road network, under extreme stress.
Johnson's coaches, based in Henley and Arden, said many of its regular services, including the school bus run, were severely delayed.
School buses invited to the Manchester News this morning to have sexual instruction at school, and said to many cancellations of other services from occupied school buses. On top of that, we have to get from Henley and Arden to Strathclyde to start service. It's taking buses upwards of an hour to get the 1.5 miles from our depot to the main part of the village to get out of the traffic.
The main route between Birmingham and London. The motorway eerily quiet.
Come on.
What would normally be the Friday rush.
So, Mark, when do we expect it to be back to normal?
Well, the southbound carriageway, Nick, there's still two lanes open to the seat, so there's probably some congestion there. Northbound carriageway, no word on when that will reopen. I understand that the resurfacing work is particularly difficult because one of the lorries involved was a milk tractor, and that milk actually got onto the surface and is making resurfacing much more difficult. Of course, if you want the latest updates, you can listen to your BBC local radio stations for the latest information, but things don't look like they're getting back to normal just yet.
Bob, thank you. Up to 20 schools in Birmingham are sending children home early every week to save money. Among them,
let me just see what happens here. Teacher. Yeah, you just fall.
Jack, what are you doing?
What?
What are you, Bob?
I'm just playing a free game, 60-second burger run. That's the thing. Right. I am just... I might do a bit of a stream on this. So, yeah. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!